Due to the question from several of the subscribers of this channel, I've been asked to analyze double pooling and in the context of, like, it seems so easy for the athletes that are at a high level to execute the double pooling in an effective way. And you can look at, for example, Andreas Nygaard, or you can look at skiers like Johannes Høstfold Klæbo. It seems so effortless. It seems so easy for them to keep speed up, and it's really easy for them to accelerate to just a few strokes. Then they pass a skier, and you see that they are really, really effective in the way they are working. And this is not easy to analyze the difference from one person to another, and why this is a good double puller and this one has a less effective technique. But one of the main factors is the timing, and timing is like the right force in the right direction at the right time. And these three factors are quite complex to analyze, and there are different ways to do this double pooling technique, and they are timing different. But one thing I would like to pay attention to is the high heel, high hip strategy that the best skiers are using. If you look at the most of the skiers, they start going up on their toes from this position, and that means that the body moves right up, and it will also go very fast down again in the same direction, and that means that the sitting position is what's going to happen. So if you look here, we worked on just this topic on the treadmill this day. So here you see that when the arms are up in position, almost in position, then you go up on the toes, and then that means that you lift yourself in this direction and not right up, and you see that it goes into the fall, and when the pools are coming into snow, you have this fall in the body, and that means that all upper body weight, the force in the arms, the force in the back muscles that are dragging the arm backwards, are in the right position when the pools are set into the snow. So this is an important thing to consider, when to go up, because if you go up too early, you will go in the right direction and it will give you a sitting position afterwards. So it's important to let the arms weight in the let the arms come up in the upper position and wait with the lift on the toe until the arms are in position, and then you go up, and then you get the right fall, you get the right amount of weight on your pulls, and everything is in position when you start the double pulling stroke. Even at this video, I mean that he could wait even a little bit longer before he went up on the toe. But still, he keeps the hip high up, and the lift comes when arms are almost in position, but I would like him to wait all to this position before he goes up on the toes. This is better. So it's like he tried to find a way and adjusting the technique due to his feeling and due to how he has done before. But I think that this is in the right way, but even it need to be a little bit more patient than he is here.